Hello guys, I feel like I haven't done a video in so long, but it's only been I think 1.5 weeks, and I do apologize that I'm uploading so late this week. I know I said this last video as well, but yeah, the last week has been very busy for me. I had to do with exams and yeah, school is just being very busy. Today's video is the first impressions and try on makeup haul kind of thing. And yeah, I'm going to try on and show you the product I bought on my face so that you can actually see how the makeup looks on. So the first product I bought was from Maybelline and it is the Fit Me foundation in the shade 105. And it is a new finish, I guess. I'm not quite sure what this is. It says luminous and smooth. Yeah, so I was really excited to try that. I actually filmed this look using all the products that I bought and then I just applied them because I wanted to tell you what I think of them. What I would say is the foundation is a light to medium coverage and it's definitely buildable, but I don't think it's a full coverage. I can still see some of my redness in my spots, so it doesn't cover everything, but I mean it's decent coverage and it feels really light on the skin and really like dewy. The foundation is also a really good colour match to my skin, so and I've got neutral undertones, so I would definitely say this foundation is a neutral foundation, but it has got a little bit of like orangey tones in it. That's a pretty good match for me, so I think I'm going to definitely go and wear this foundation in school because this was only €8 and I think you can't go wrong with €8 and like a decent coverage is enough for school. So for those of you who can't wear that much makeup in school, I think this foundation will be perfect because it's really light, you can build it up to medium coverage and it's not like a full-on foundation. So what I would say is it's definitely a decent foundation, and if you have got more dry skin and neutral undertones, I would definitely have a look at the foundation to sum the foundation up. The foundation is really dewy and hydrating and a really good colour match for neutral undertones and also for orange undertones, and it gives a decent coverage, a light to medium coverage, and it's really not a pricey foundation. And I would give this foundation probably a 7 out of 10, just because it's not like full coverage, you really have to build it up. The next product I want to talk with you about is the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. And I'm in the shade 15, and I'm normally the lightest shade, which is 10, but actually the lightest shade is 15 because the 10 one was really pink toned and it looked kind of darker than 15, so I paid 15 up. This is actually a pretty good match for my skin. However, I would prefer something a little bit lighter under my under eyes, just to brighten my under eye area a little bit. But I haven't come across any concealer that is lighter than my skin, so I don't know. I'm really, really pale, and I can't find anything that is lighter than my skin. It's so hard for me to even find something that matches my skin. So what I wanted to say about this, I would not recommend buying it. I mean, it's a decent concealer, but I have definitely tried better ones and it does not cover that much. It is really thick when you first apply it, but after you've blended it in a little bit, it doesn't anymore. So I don't think it's good, and it has also settled into my little lines right here. I really wouldn't recommend buying this, and also the shade variety is not that good. I think there are only 4 shades. I would give this concealer a 3 to let's say 4 out of 10. The next product I want to show you is a MAC lipstick, and oh my god, MAC lipsticks are so expensive, but I really wanted a MAC lipstick, and this one is my first MAC lipstick, and I'm so excited. I love this lipstick. I actually have used this before, and I also have used this in a recent video, so this is not really first impression, but yeah, I really like this. When I tried it in the shop, I was immediately sold by the fact that it was so moisturizing on my lips. The lipstick feels so creamy and buttery, and yeah, I'm just amazed by it. So the lipstick is called Hue, and I think you probably have all heard about this lipstick. It looks like this. It's a really nice nude shade, and you can't see it too much. It's not too bright. Yeah, I really like this for everyday wear. I'm using this all the time right now. I'm absolutely in love with this lipstick, and I think I would give this lipstick an 8 out of 10 just because this lipstick doesn't stay on for that long and kind of exaggerates my dry lips, and yeah, that's why I just give it an 8 out of 10. The next product I want to show you is one of the L'Oreal Paris lip glosses, and it is this one. It's in the shade 209 Violet. This lip gloss comes with a little applicator end with the lip gloss in here, and on the other side comes with like a little balm which has some glitter in it, and you just put this on top to make your lipstick a little bit shiny, and I am absolutely 100% in love with this lip gloss. It's so amazing. It stays on so long. I've actually got some lipstick still on my on the back of my hand from swatches I did earlier, and I have had to rub really hard to get it off. I literally sat here for like 10 minutes just trying to get it off. So when you first apply it, it is more of a liquid, and later on it dries to a matte finish, and then you obviously put the balm over the top. When you go to the drugstore, pick one of those up. They're incredible. They stay on so long. And yeah, they're so pigmented and the shades are beautiful. So yeah, I think I have to give this a 10 out of 10. I don't normally do that. I always say there's room for improvement, but I'm just absolutely in love with this. The next thing I bought today is the Catrice Liquid Liner in Waterproof. A friend recommended this to me, so I thought I would give it a try, and I believe this was only £3.50. Yeah, this was £3.50, and oh my god, I really like this. It's so easy to apply. I'm really rubbish at applying liquid eyeliner, and I think I haven't applied liquid liner since forever, I think since Christmas, because I'm just rubbish and I didn't have a liquid liner that I wanted to use, but oh my god, I can see myself wearing liquid liner more often. I really like this. And what I noticed is it didn't smudge so far, which my old liquid liner did. Just after I applied my liquid liner and I opened my eyes, it got all over my lids. This liquid liner didn't do that. Also, I got really precise lines, and yeah, it was just really easy to work with. This is super black, so I would definitely recommend this, as it's also really cheap. And yeah, I think, what do you give this? I would say 7. I don't know why, but this number just pops into my head. I don't know why. I obviously haven't tested it throughout the whole day. This is actually the best liquid liner I have used in my entire life, but I've only used like 3 liquid liners. I'm not like as experienced as other YouTubers might be, but yeah, I really like this. So the last makeup item I bought over the last 2 months are the Ardell Demi Wispies. Obviously they are not in the packet because I've got them on. So the only thing I don't like about the lashes is that they get longer at the end, and I don't really like how that looks on myself. But yeah, I've not as experienced with fake lashes either. I've only ever tried, I think, 3 different ones. And yeah, I really like how natural they look, but I don't like how they flare out at the end and get longer. I don't like that at all. Ardell lashes are always really, really good. They are a bit pricey in Germany. I think they are €7, and in America they're only like $3, and yeah, that's a bit annoying, but they are made out of real hair, I guess. I think I would give them an 8 out of 10. So I hope you enjoyed this little haul, and I hope you also enjoyed that I actually put the makeup on my face. And if you did enjoy my video, please give it a like, or if you want to see more of me, please subscribe. It would mean so, so much to me. And yeah, I see you next week. Bye!